are Elijah,
yeah,
or Jeremiah, or one of the prophets.
Yes, sir.
But then the Lord put it to her and said, who do you say,
yeah,
that I, the Son of Man, am?
Yeah.
All right? And then Peter rose up and said, thou art the Christ.
That's what he said.
I'm the Son of the living God.
Yeah.
I want to just pose to you this point. You can never know who you are until you know who God is.
That's right.
You will never know who you fully are until you know who God is.
Amen.
And once you get the revelation of who God is, God is going to pull out what he sowed in you, what he put in you, what was covered and hidden is about to come to the surface. Tell your neighbor, I feel a resurrection right now. I feel that seed rising. I feel the Spirit of God moving in my soul.
Yeah.
Come on now.
I wish I had time. I would take you back to Genesis.
Yeah.
I was sharing with the church. Folk talk about God. It took God 7 days to create the earth. The Bible doesn't say that.
That's right.
What the Bible says that God, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He spoke the world into existence,
yes, right,
with his word.
Yeah.
Everything was in the world. Everything was in the earth. But sin came in and caused chaos. And everything that God created in perfection was now in a chaotic state.
Uh-huh.
Everything was in darkness and underwater.
Yeah.
And then the Spirit moved on the water.
Yeah.
And the earth had to be born again. So that which was in there, that which was already put in there by God, could come back to the light,
yeah,
could come back to the surface, that the world might be manifested according to the will of God and not the will of the enemy.
Yeah, right. Amen.
That's right.
Let's go back. The gift, read. Who's reading?
Even so, minister the same one to another.
In other words, God has given you a gift, and it is not for you to get puffed up.
Ooh. Yeah,
that's right.
It's not for you to claim a title.
Yes, sir.
It's not for you to get the fame and the glory.
Yeah.
Huh? It is for you to be a blessing to the body,
yeah,
of Christ. Tell your neighbor, I'm here to bless you this morning.
Yeah.
Read.
Yeah.
As good stewards of the manifold grace of God.
In other words, I have this gift by the grace, mm-hmm, of God.
Yeah.
I have any teachers here? Mm-hmm. Teachers, stand up, teachers. How many of you knew you were going to be a teacher before you got the job? One or two? Sit down. I got any administrators here?
Mm-hmm.
Able to organize, stand up. I need administrators. Hold on. Got two, three. Hold on. Okay, I want y'all to stay right there. Everybody look around. What is wrong with the picture that we see?
It's women.
All women.
Women.
So brothers, are we saying that we are unorganized and disorganized without women? Without our wives? We're not. Huh? So I know you are organized. I know you are. I've seen you at work. Amen. Many of us have that gift. Y'all sit down. All right? But yet it didn't come out until we were born again.
Yeah.
And God, through the Holy Ghost, began to bring that gift out of us, that others could see it, that they saw the blessing. And guess what they saw, y'all?
The fruit
of the gift being present. Yeah. Let's go look further. Read.
If any man speak,
what?
Let him speak as the oracles of God.
In other words, don't you speak for yourself.
Come on.
Yeah.
Don't you get up there and try to pretend like you got a word from God. Tell somebody, and thus said the Lord, or the Lord told me. I'll tell you, neighbor, don't do it.
Right.
If God didn't tell you, don't you?
Don't say it.
But if God tells you, this is the travesty. This is the thing that hurts the church. When God gives one of the members of the body a message for the body and they don't deliver.
Oh yeah.
What would you do if you found out your mailman had mail for you or special delivery and you found out he was keeping it in his truck, all the time, and you happen to walk by the truck and see your name on packages in the back of his truck? What would you do?
Come on,
man. That's on
I think you would go to his boss. Can I say to the church today, somebody needs to pray to God,
yeah,
that whoever it is that he is speaking to you right now, at this moment, in this body, that they will deliver the message this morning.
All right.
And y'all see how y'all getting?
Go ahead.
See, people get nervous now.
Oh, yeah.
See, because the deacons and preachers, they be the only ones supposed to have a message.
Yeah.
No.
If God
will give, I'll give you an example. I was running a revival down in South Carolina years ago. And a young lady, never been in church before, came in the church. And when I looked at her, the Lord put a picture in front of me, almost like this, like a screen. Show me her taking something, putting it behind the left side of her dresser, a picture with a little package. And that's all I saw. When we made the altar call, she's the first one to come into the line. And as she comes into the line, the Lord has me to speak. I said, sis, I said, are you ready to be saved? Because everybody understand this, that the gifts are for the edification of the body.
All right.
It's all about souls and salvation. Can I get an amen from everybody? It's about souls and salvation. And so when she comes up, and I said, sister, I said, are you ready to give your life to the Lord? Are you ready to be saved? She said, yes. Yes, I am. I said, well, first thing the Lord told me to tell you, when you go home, that thing that you hid on your dresser, behind the picture, on the left side of your dresser, go home and flush it down the toilet. She fell out. Mm-hmm. But she got baptized in Jesus' name tonight. And I heard she went home. Guess what it was? It was her next hit of cocaine. And she flushed it down the toilet, and now she's been in church ever since.
Oh, yeah.
That's what the gifts are supposed to do, to push the person to God, to get their attention, because they know I didn't know her, but God knows everybody. God knows everything, and God will speak.
Yes, we will.
The question is, will you?
Hallelujah.
I want church that is exciting now. I want that evangelistic spirit in the house all the time, not sometimes, all the time.
Yes, sir.
Look at the church in the book of Acts. Do you know why? Oh, man, help me.
Come on, go ahead.
Do you know why so many folk were saved? Because the gifts were being manifested daily.
Yeah.
And God added to the church such as should be saved daily. Oh, come on, somebody. Tell your neighbor, I can't go back to church, to dead church anymore. I can't be the same person I was. I got a message, hallelujah, that we got to come alive through the Spirit of God.
Oh, yeah.
I got to cut across the field. So we understand, and y'all go home and study for yourself, but we understand that what Paul is writing about in Romans is the gift that God has placed in us.